We've got some difficult days ahead. But it really doesn't matter to me now. Because I've been to the mountaintop.
Hi, my name is Belle Brockhoff. I'm 21 years old and I am a snowboard athlete. The discipline I do is boardercross. So you're racing down in heats of six and you go over jumps, turns and all that stuff. And the top three go to the next round. So it's a process of elimination.
So Cam, what do you like most about boardercross?
It's fun.
Yeah?
Boardercross is my favourite thing to do in the world, and get out there, match transitions, generate speed, and race close with your friends and competitors and try and beat them to the bottom of the hill.
You know, I just like racing. For me, it's all about pushing all my snowboard skills that we get out here on the mountain, like we do when we're ripping around on a free ride day, and put it into a contest format. So, yeah, wouldn't want to be doing anything else with my life.
For me, it's a lot more fun than your skiing, going in between jet gates, or your cross country just going up one track, or your snowboard GS and so on, where you're just going around a few gates. Boardercross, like I said before, it's fast, you get the adrenaline pumping, but then every single course that you go on is different. There's different features, different turns, jumps, heights, you know, different speeds. You know, it just keeps things interesting, because like for me, other snow sports is kind of like swimming. I'm not saying swimming is a bad thing, but you're following the one line up and back, and I find to me that's boring. I had a huge fear of jumps, so I had to overcome that, and I did it in an interesting way. I just wait till age helped me get over that. So I just stuck with PGS and PSL, which is a different discipline besides boardercross. And eventually, after I got tired of that sport, I just decided, oh, all right, let's just give boardercross another go, and it just clicked. Oh, Kelly Slater. So far, he's not just only an incredible athlete, you know, he's won 11 world championship titles. He's just like, his mind is incredible with like as an athlete, and how he can play tricks on other athletes as well. And just he's just one of the top athletes in the world, and it's awesome. And also, like on the snowboarding side, it would have to be Mayelle Ricker, who's Canadian and she's a snowboard crosser. When I got my first podium result at World Cup, I probably had a little bit of luck in the last final heat, which was the medal round heat. But that was a big wow for me. Like, I didn't expect that. You know, I trained this season before that really, really hard, and it showed to me like that hard work that I've never done before, you know, paid off. It's just a board sport, and I love board sports like surfing, skateboarding, and just how you can just go like super fast. And that's like one of the reasons why I got into boardercross, is that you can go super fast, you can hit jumps, you can do tricks, and it's just an adrenaline sport too. You know, it's a dangerous sport, and it's just a lot of fun. Benefits, you got to keep fit. You know, if you want to go really far with snowboarding, you have to keep physically fit. You work on your mental toughness, so you become a stronger person mentally. You get to meet great people around the world and expand your connections, and you get to travel the world. That's awesome. You know, not many people, especially my age, 21 years old, they get to travel the world and do something that they love. Just having so much fun, like just after each run, when you have all this adrenaline pumping through, you're finishing the run, you just feel yourself, look at your hands and they're shaking. Just having a smile on your face, look around to your other teammates, you know, it's also smile and say, that was bloody awesome, let's go do that again. You know, you just repeat that and just have an awesome time. Rules, I reckon, maintain good respect on tour. So don't be an asshole. Like, have that mutual professional respect for every racer, because you never know what's going to happen in the race. You know, if you have respect, people might, you know, do something for you in between. Like, if there's like a really tight gap, and the only way that you can make that gap or line is to take that really tight line through there, and someone else could take you out. If you have no respect, people can choose to take you out, or they could back off a little bit, say, hey, look, you know, I respect you, I don't want to take you out. So that's what respect can do for you. And also they can help you out, you know, invite you to training camps, you know, train with them as a buddy, all these little different things really. Remember, each time you hop on track or you compete, remember that you're in that sport for a reason. It's because you have a lot of fun. You're not in the sport to win. You're not in the sport to get a lot of sponsors. You're in this sport because you love it. And when you love something, your results will come with that anyway. Yeah, like, just see it develop more, and like each year we see more and more kids get involved, and just hopefully we can get like a course set up one day and just train all together. It'll be sweet.